Okay, hello. I'm taking another iteration on this. It was kind of fun sharing it on Twitter because this was like the first iteration and got some feedback and were a couple of things like feedback both internally and on Twitter. So let me just go through it once more and tell you about the changes. And if you haven't seen it before, I'll reiterate what we're trying to do as well. The thing is, in Codesandbox, we have generally a lot of complexity. One of those complexities is modals. Even though we only show one at a time, it's where we want to trigger them from. That's the complexity. And also that when we trigger a model, we want to get some feedback related to opening it. So let's just go into it. So the API we kind of want here is to be able to point to our actions and some models and a specific model and open it and optionally give it a payload because it might be a generic model. So we want to change the title, for example. And one of the things here is one of the complexities as well is that we have typing and we want this to work really well with typing. So to manage this payload, it would be nice to have a general open action instead, and then we would rather pass in what model we want to open. But typing that up, like figuring out what type of payload should it be based on the type of model you pass in, like I don't know even where to begin to do that. And we don't want to write a lot of typing. We want that to work automatically. So currently, every model gets its own key where the typing matches that key. And also complexity here is that when we close a model, we want it to resolve the opening of that model. So the result here will get the payload on closing. And of course, the typing should work here as well. So if we close with a string, we open and return a string. And then there's a change here. David, the guy behind who talks a lot about state machines, every time I write isLoading somewhere in an example, he's right there. He just pops up and he says, you shouldn't write isLoading. And in this case, we were using isOpen on each model. Especially since we only show one model at a time, it doesn't make any sense to have possibly multiple models open. So now I changed it so that instead of each model saying is open, it's saying is current. And the reason I did that is because we do have the current model in our state, but we certainly do not want to check if a model is open by doing this. Basically checking on if current is the string, like the key, because that the typing doesn't work. And to do that, we would basically need enums, and those are super great and looks really nice this way. But then we have to import the model type in all the files that needs this. And also when we trigger the actions, we can't trigger them by exploring. Like we have to import a model and then use that as that enum as a lookup when we look into the models. So it's just, we lose the exploratory part of it. So instead, we have isCurrent on every model, and this is not something we control. This is a derived state, so it automatically says true on only one of them, because only one model can be current. Okay, so what I also did now is that when we define a model, we can define that in a models file. And a model is just an object where we define a result. So that's what's returned from opening it. And this is the default result. So in this case, it's Boolean. But if the result is by default nothing, but it should be something probably, or maybe, you can type it like this. You can say that if there's something here, it's a git commit. Some models might have different kinds of responses when you open them, and then you can type it like this. So it doesn't have anything by default, but it could be type A or type B. What we also want is to have state in these models. So for example, a confirm model has a title and a description, and we might use it for many different things. So this is what we're doing up here. We're passing in a payload that needs to be typed, and that is merged into the state of. So you have default state, and then you merge that new state into the state of the model. So defining a model is super simple. And then there is this factory called create models, which handles all the typing. And it's kind of crazy that it just works. We can have a quick look at it. And these models we create with the rest of our namespaces, the rest of our state and actions and everything. So every model will now be its own component. It defines itself as a model, and it can directly use Overmind to point to the specific model state it's using. So for example, this is the confirm model. It points to state models confirm is current to figure out if it's open or not. And then we point to actions models confirm close to close it. Or we use, this should be close. Or we close it with a payload, and all of this stuff is typed. Like everything is typed, exploratory and typed. I can show you quickly here. So I'm just in some random action in Overmind. And if we point to actions here, we can see we have models. We have confirm create file, which is just a model. And then we can open it. And this one expects to get a partial of this simple foo. Maybe we can look at it first, sorry. This is my model, confirm create file. It has a default state of foo bar. The result is false by default. So when I open it, I have to pass in a partial of the state. So it merges that in. And then if I do const result here, and I await that, and we can see that the result is a boolean, which is cool. And then if I try to close it immediately, I have my confirm, close. We can see that it requires a boolean. And all this happened only because I created this object. I got all the typing for free, and that's partly Overmind and partly the factory I created. That's pretty awesome. Let's move on. But some of these models should be more generic. They shouldn't be attached to Overmind, like this one, because we're using it in an embed, for example. Well, in those cases, we just create a normal component, and we have to set props for what it's supposed to have. So in this case, it's just open and close. And then when we're inside Codesandbox, we use that component in combination with Overmind and pass in the state as props. Well, some models are only for Codesandbox, and they might, as we see here, just use it directly. So we can choose what should be generic or what should be specific to Codesandbox. and then what's nice about this is that currently we have all our models in one file. And now we are able to split them up and implement them where they're actually used. So in this case, the confirm create file model is related to VS Code, for example. So what we gain here is that we have this one file that describes all the models in the application. But we still produce the UI where it actually is in the UI, if that makes sense. So we also separate like the state of a model from the UI description. We need to open models from one place and close it from a different place, and we can do that. So for example, one action can open a model, and then a completely different action can close it. And that is something we have achieved now. But that's not only inside actions in Overmind. Also, we can pass actions into effects. So for example, VS Code is able to trigger these models from inside VS Code because we're passing them in when we initialize the effect, as we call it. And then, of course, from a component, we are able to open the models. So some examples of what we actually want to use this for is that we have VS Code. We need to trigger models from VS Code. In this case, we want a generic confirm model where we can set the title and the description, and we pass that into VS Code. And then we also want to use confirm from embed. So in the embed, we use the confirm component and we pass in the state. So that means that there is a confirm component as well inside Codesandbox, which uses the confirm model and passes in state from Overmind instead. We also want to close these models. So for example, we have a deployment model, and when we're done deploying, we want to close that model. So we click it, we start deploying. If it's a successful deploy, we want to close it. If it's not successful, we want to show an error and certainly not close it. And like we could, for example, open it in a component, and then we could listen for or wait for the action to resolve, and then we could close or open the model based on some returned result. But that's a limitation. Like, then we have to wait for that resolved result, and that's not always what we want to do, and it separates the logic. But also we have live mode, so with this approach we are also able to pass this information over the wire when you're in live mode. So if one person opens a model, we are able to send a message and open the model on the other client as well. And what's the other video? Let's see if we go to Codesandbox here. And even though I haven't implemented any UI, we can start to take a look at how this actually works. So this is all the state currently. We are like partly into the refactor, so this will actually change a little bit. But we have models here. So we can see we don't have any current model. And we have this confirm create file model, which has a state called foo bar. This is the one I showed you previously, and we derived that this isn't the current model. So if we move to the actions now, we can see that I've already found the, let's see, confirm create file open, and this wanted, what was it, foo bar 2, for example. And I can trigger that action now, and this actually runs on the client. And when I do this, we can see in the DevTools that we set the current model to confirm create file. And then we merged in the bar 2 state into confirm create file foo. And if we go to our state now, we go down to models, we can see the current one is confirm create file. We update the state, and even the derived state says that this one is now current. So if I were to go in here, export const, some model, results, blah, something like that. And if we go in here now, and I'll again trigger this action, we should see that we now have two, where one is true and the other is false. If we now trigger some model, models, some model open. Let's see if this works. We change to some model. I can look into my state. Now we see that confirm create file is current false and some model is true. So this is actually working. And what was really nice about this is that the only code that was really necessary for this was to create models and defining the models like this. And then we have this factory thing that isn't much code. It's 30 lines of code or something. which should give us all the freedom we need to handle anything that comes down the road. And as I mentioned in the previous video, this is about, like, ideally you want a model to be like just a component, you control it from within a component. But as you can see with the different things we need to do inside Codesandbox, that doesn't work. And there are like a few very specific examples that kind of breaks that isolation principle. And that is passing stuff on live and also passing stuff to side effects. So stuff outside the core application needs to trigger stuff inside the core application. Okay. Anyways, I hope this was useful in some sense, and thanks for all the feedback. It was fun doing this, and I hope we can do this more as we continue our journey to refactor Codesandbox. Bye-bye.